Welcome back alongside Zach Robinson. I'm Mike Renner. Today we're going to be talking about the three things to watch for the Buffalo Bills heading into training camp. And it's hard to ignore the losses along that offensive line with Cordy Glenn, while he didn't play a ton of snaps last year, getting traded to the Cincinnati Bengals. Richie Incognito gone. Eric Wood gone. That whole left side decimated now. Really only Deion Dawkins, the hope of being, you know, good in his in that place. What are they going to do, especially with the young quarterbacks behind them?
It looks rough. You know, they signed Russell Bodine in free agency, who has not graded well for the Bengals the past few years. You look just across the board, a lot of holes, you know, up front. So, like you said, it's going to whoever the quarterback ends up being can't feel too great about what's in front of them.
Yeah, it might not be the worst offensive line in the NFL because guys like Vladimir Ducasse and, you know, John Miller have proven that they can be, you know, at least competent at their positions, but they went from a top 10 offensive line in our grading system last year to now one of the bottom five heading into preseason in our offensive line rankings. It's just not going to look good for either LeSean McCoy running the ball behind it or the quarterback who has to throw.
Yeah, and a lot of it may come down to Brian Daboll schematically, you know, doing things, helping them out with the screen game, getting creative somehow, getting the ball out of these quarterbacks' hands because and if they get caught in a drop-back pass game, it could be pretty tough.
Could be issues, and that's not good for a young quarterback. On to the second biggest thing, and it's the lack of playmakers on that offense. Now they have Kelvin Benjamin, Zay Jones as their 1-2 wide receivers, but Zay Jones had one of the worst rookie seasons we've ever seen from a wide receiver heading into the NFL. Was just wholly unproductive there. Kelvin Benjamin, we know his issues about being able to separate down the field. That's why the Panthers were willing to part ways with him. And all of a sudden now LeSean McCoy may be involved in some investigation off the field stuff that might limit his playing time. So what are they going to do on the outside?
It looks tough. On the outside, there's really nobody that looks to be that elite guy that you can rely on week in and week out to move the chains. Charles Clay, the tight end, probably their best skill guy without LeSean McCoy. But receiver-wise, Andre Holmes, Brandon Riley, just a bunch of guys that they need to step up and stats show and the history shows that maybe those aren't the guys that you want out there.
Yeah, and there's really no young guys in there that they brought in, besides maybe Zay Jones taking a leap in his year two, but when we saw from year one, it was pretty ugly. So not a lot of hope there on the outside. And then flip to the opposite side of the ball where there is some hope. They were one of the best defenses in the NFL a year ago, despite having the second worst team pass rushing productivity in the entire NFL. They didn't have much of a pass rush, still had great pass coverage. Now, though, there's hope that defensive line might have come a ways and be one of the better ones.
Yeah, definitely. You look at Star Latouille, Harrison Phillips, kind of some better run defenders to help stir up the run game a little bit. If Trent Murphy can get back and stay healthy, he had a good season in 2016. So there's some hope there. Schematically, with what Sean McDermott does, I think he does one of the best jobs in the NFL of just knowing guys, their strengths, everything, and just kind of playing a brand of football week to week, game plan wise, it could change up, and he does a great job of mixing it up with different pressure. So he definitely can help out this defensive line.
And like I said, it would be crazy to see how good this defense could get if a guy like Shaq Lawson, a former first round pick, starts to take a step forward, or if Trent Murphy gets back to that form, and you have Jerry Hughes productive across from him as well. All of a sudden, that takes this defense to the next level and could shore up some issues that they might have offensively. On to the positional battle that we're going to be watching here, and it's obvious. It's the quarterback position. They've signed A.J. McCarron in free agency. They have Nathan Peterman, sort of the incumbent, and then obviously Josh Allen, top 10 pick. Who comes out on top here?
Yeah, it's going to be tough to see. I think that, you know, Nathan Peterman, obviously that first game against the Chargers, his first start could not have gone worse. It was a disaster. Has the pass rush in his face, batted balls going everywhere. Tough spot for him. A.J. McCarron, we've seen him play pretty well in spots in Cincinnati, but whatever you do, you hope that Josh Allen does not have to play in year one behind this offensive line. The playmakers, you hope that he can kind of sit and get groomed, but I think of these guys, I wouldn't be surprised if Nathan Peterman came out on top. You know, kind of an efficient, knows where to go with the ball, can get the ball out of his hands. That might be what they need because it doesn't look like they're going to be an explosive offense by any means.
Yeah, I like what you said there about hopefully Josh Allen doesn't get to have to see the field because we already touched on it with the losses along the offensive line, the lack of playmakers on the outside. It's not a situation that anyone's set up to succeed for. You know, it could be Aaron Rodgers wouldn't be set up to succeed in this offense, let alone a rookie who's coming from Wyoming making this huge leap in competition. So I have no beat on who's going to win it, but like you mentioned, hopefully it's not Josh Allen. Hopefully he gets that year to develop. there you have it. That's what we're watching for with the Bills heading into training camp. Make sure to go to the PFF YouTube channel to check out all 32 team previews.